Hello ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to part 14 of the creation kit tutorial series. This is going to be a multi-part video. Today we're just going to do part 1, and we're going to be looking at quest design finally. Yep, it's finally time. We're going to learn how to make a quest, and it's going to be brutal. Gotta be honest, it's not easy at first, but you do get used to it. It all becomes easier with practice, as most things in life. And today we're going to focus on the coolest bit. Anyway, we are going to make some dialogue. We are finally going to have characters that can talk to us based on the input. Well, based on the options we give them, blah 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 blah. So if you've ever wanted to learn how to do dialogue, now's the time. Hurrah! Right, let's get a move on, shall we? As always, file, data, load Skyrim.esm, and we are going to be putting this in Naxx's tomb, which is the dungeon I've made. So obviously I've got that set as the active file. Now, you don't need a dungeon you've already made. It would help, because there isn't that many empty dungeons in the game, but it's entirely possible to make a quest completely using spaces already in the game, so don't worry about it if you don't have a dungeon of your own. Okie dokie. So the first thing we need to do, and you do need to do this before you make your quest, is to build an NPC who's going to give you the quest. You need a quest giver before we can actually make the quest. So that's what we're going to quickly do. I have done a tutorial on creating NPCs, so I'm not really going to go through this process in detail. Actors, actor, actor, right click on the list on the right, click new, and that'll load up the actor edit window like so. ID, you know what to do. We're going to call it new quest actor. Name, we need a name for our NPC. What's in my continuing tradition? I'm going to find something in my room. I have a dolphin puppet, which isn't a fantastic name, so we're going to change it a bit. We're going to call it a dolphin puppet. And short name is for the Radiant AI quest system. So if there's a randomly generated quest that involves your person, that's the name it'll use. We're just going to call him dolphin. That's really not that important. Now the other thing we need to do is tick unique. And that means there's only one of these NPCs in the game, as opposed to like a fox and there's thousands of them. And we're going to go down and pick a race. It's going to be Khajiit. Now, we can change the inventory, as I've shown you in the past, or you just click inventory and change an outfit, and we can also change his character gem parts, which, you know, this allows us to edit the look of our character. We really don't care at this point. I'm just going to click OK and make the actor. You know, I'm not here to show you how to make an NPC. Go check out my first video in the Creation Kit tutorial series if you want to know that. The playlist will be linked in the description, as always, so just go to the first video and you'll see how to do this in a bit more detail. But generally, creating NPCs is a very basic process. So we've got our NPC made. If we go into object, type new quest actor, there he is. There is Dolphin Puppet. So we need to give this guy a quest. To do that, we want to go to character, quest, in the object window. And you'll get a big list of quests. So we're going to right click, click new, and now we can start building our quest. So the ID, we're going to stick with the same first two words. We're going to call it new quest, and I always find it's a good idea with all your IDs that are revolved around one thing to give them all the same first couple of words in the ID. This puts them all together, it kind of makes it easier to search for them. You always know what you're looking for. We could have called it Dolphin Puppet, whatever, but new quest, and then we're going to call it, well, new quest, quest, because that's what it is. The quest name, so we need a name for our quest. Usually helps if you've got an idea what the quest is going to be about. This one, all we're going to have is a thief has stolen Dolphin's ring or amulet or something and gone and hid out in Naxx's tomb. We're going to have to go kill the thief, get the ring back, and take it back to Dolphin. So we're going to call the quest Dolphin's Turmoil, because it sounds cool. Priority is, basically, there's some NPCs in the game that have multiple quests related to them. Which quest takes priority depends on their number of priority. The default for most standard quests is 60 for most standard side quests. Just go for 60, that'll work out fine, generally speaking. If you really want your quest to be the most important and you know you've got other quests attached to the same NPC, feel free to up or lower the priority depending on what. So 100 priority means that is the most important quest, and that is the quest that the NPC will deal with and present the dialogue options for. Well, the only other thing we need to change here is type, and we're going to change that to side quests. Type is simply when you load up your quest menu, your quest log, you've seen the little graphic next to the name and stuff that denotes what type of quest it is. That's all this is deciding. We want it to be a side quest, so that means it's got its own quest sort of page, unlike miscellaneous ones, which all get stacked together with just the general gist of the quest. Then we're going to click OK. Give that a second. And we've made our quest, so we're going to search for it again and load it back up. You do have to do this. You do have to click OK and then load it back up, because I don't know if you noticed, but we now have a lot more options up here. We didn't have all of these a minute ago because, simply because you have to click OK and get your quest into the object window before all these options become available. So just click OK and load the quest back up. Now there's only two things we actually need to do here, although one of them is going to take a long time. First things first, we're going to go to quest stages, and it's always a good idea in your mind to have quest stages in mind. You know, stage one of a quest is before you've even met the quest giver, stage two is you've got the quest, stage three in our example is we've killed the bandit, stage four would be we have obtained the ring, and stage five would be we've given the ring back to Dolphin and we've completed the quest. So we need to put all these down as individual quest stages, and then in the future that lets us to refer to each part of the quest and then push the quest along. You'll see as we go along what I mean, but just know that we need to make individual stages for each section of quest per se. So we're going to do that. We've got a section here on the left, the index box. We're going to right click, click new, and this is going to be stage one. Just leave it as zero, that means it's the base, you know, the lowest possible stage. So we need to make another one. We're going to right click new and it will assign it zero again. We actually want that to be called stage 10. Now the reason we call it stage 10 instead of, well, index 10 instead of index 1 is because in terms of basically if we ever wanted to add a stage between 0 and 1 again, let's say we wanted to have part of the quest where you have to go meet someone else and do another quest before you can go and talk to Dolphin. If we set the index to stage 1, we won't be able to do that because there's no room between 0, which is the base point, and 1. If we set it to 10, we could add index 5 and just have another stage before, you know, the stage where you go and talk to Dolphin. So it's always a good idea to go up in stages of 10. So let's call that 20. This is the one where you've killed the bandit. 30, you've obtained the ring. 40, you've given the ring back to Dolphin. So you've got 5 stages in a basic quest. You could have more, you could have less. That's all we're doing there. For safety reasons, I like to click OK again. Not really sure why. And let's go back to new quest, edit, and if we go to quest stages, there they are. But all of that pales with what we're about to do. We're about to do some dialoguing. Fantastic. Sorry about that. Now, you want to go to the tab called Dialogue Views, and a view is basically a bundle of dialogue. It contains topics and branches and responses and all this stuff we're going to talk about. All you need to know is a view is a collection of dialogue, all revolving around the same idea, basically. So we want to make a view that is all about Dolphin's quest for his ring. We want all this dialogue to be centered in one view about Dolphin's turmoil, the quest. So we're going to make a new view. On the left, dialogue view, you want to right click, go to new. Just call it new quest, and we're going to call it a view at the end. Click OK. It'll give you a topic name in a second, or it usually does. It should pop up with a topic name as well. Just click OK to that. Don't need to worry about that. And now what we need to do is make the first part of our dialogue. We're going to make the dialogue that happens when you first go and speak to Dolphin. So usually when you go talk to a quest giver, what happens is you'll be given an option, for example, what's wrong, or is something wrong, or is there anything I can help you with, something like that. So that's the quest, that's the stage we're going to do. And to do this, we need to start creating branches. And branches are just links between different dialogue bits. You'll see. Go to the right in this big white box here, right click, create branch. So we're going to create the first part of our branch, which can then link to other sections of text and allow us to, you know how you talk to an NPC and sometimes you'll click an option and then suddenly two options of dialogue will appear? You know, you've got 3 or 4 dialogue options to advance your quest, or to say no to the quest, or to say I really like your hat. That's all a branch is. It's just another a text option in the list of text. So we need our new branch ID. We're going to call this new quest, and then it's the first stage, so we're just going to call it hello. And this is where the topic pops up. Just click OK to that. All that does is give the topic the same name as the branch. The branch is, you know, the tree of text. You know what I mean when I say a branch, how all the text links together. The topic is the first topic, is basically what is the topic of the conversation. And you'll end up with this box like this. You can move it around. Usually, decided It doesn't want to move around at the moment. But there we go. And we need to add some dialogue into here. So what we're going to do is double click on this bar here, the new quest hello topic. You want to double click on that. Give that a second to load. I'm sorry if it's a bit loud outside. There's people being sociable. It's crazy. And as you see, we open up this topic window. So topic text is, well, the text of the topic. What topic do you want to discuss? Every option in a list of text when you're talking to an NPC is a topic. So our first topic is going to be something along the lines of, do you want any help, or what's wrong, or what's up, bro? Because that's how people talk in Skyrim. So the topic text, what's up, bro? When you first go talk to Dolphin, the text, what's up, bro, will pop up. You then click on that option and he will give a response, which we're going to now write. This is the response sort of block here. To make a new one, we're going to right click. Eventually. Any minute now, and click new. So my laptop's definitely having a slow day. And this will give you this bar here called new response. So we need to write our response text. We're going to say, what's up, bro? What is Dolphin Puppet going to say in return? Well, we want him to tell us that he's had his ring stolen. His glorious ring has been stolen by a bandit and taken to Nax's tomb. So, some lemon stole my ring. He took it to Nax's tomb to... spelled wrong. To do God knows what with it. Do me a favour, lad. Go and rescue it. Ta. Obviously, if you're writing a serious quest and it's not through a tutorial, you want to maybe tone down the words like lemon and lad and ta. But for now, we're just writing the response. We are doing this seriously. It's completely up to you what dialogue you want to use. Now, we can also set an emotion type. This is basically... oh no. When you first click after writing something, what it does is it does a spell check. If there's something spelt wrong, such as this, which actually isn't spelt wrong, it's spelt the proper English way, and Bethesda's obviously American. No, something. Isn't Bethesda French? Anyways, not the point. It'll pop up with a spell check. If you're sure you've spelled everything right, like Nax's tomb, it's going to cry at me for as well. If we click ignore, tar's wrong. Just ignore them. If your spelling's right, just ignore it. But if it's there to highlight spell mistakes you may well have made. Obviously, when you're writing a lot of dialogue, some typos may enter your text every now and again. Now we can go to emotion type. This is all about the audio when he's talking. The emotion type is what facial expression will the NPC have while he's talking. So, he's sad. You know, someone stole his ring. We want him to look sad. So just tick sad, tick whatever you want. This basically, like I said, just controls his facial emotion. Obviously, it's not going to control his tone of voice or anything, because there is not recorded NPC dialogue for this response here. Nobody at Bethesda recorded the line, "Some lemon stole my ring." As much as we hope they would, they haven't. So we are actually going to record our own dialogue as well. But you want to click OK. And we're going to start adding something called a condition. And a condition is basically something that has to happen in order for this dialogue option to appear. Because at the moment in time, if we go up to any NPC in the game, the topic text, what's up, bro, will pop up as a dialogue option. We could then click it and they would go and say, some lemon stole my ring. We don't want that. Obviously, we don't want that. So what we need to do is restrict this topic info and topic text just to Dolphin. To do that, we go to the conditions box, we right click, we click new, and most of this is terrifying, but condition function get his ID. This is basically what is the condition, and the condition is get his ID, and that means as long as the person talking fits the ID we're going to select, then they will have the dialogue option. No other IDs will, unless you go and set more get his IDs, so that way you could have three different people who all offer you the same quest. So we want get his ID as our condition function, and we're going to go and click on invalid. Clicking on invalid basically brings up the option to select an NPC. So when this box pops up in a second, we're going to go down and select new quest actor, which was the name we gave Dolphin Puppet. And that way, basically the quest will run a search for the ID of the person talking, and if it is new quest actor, then it will present the dialogue option. New quest actor, click OK. And click OK. And there you go. Only Dolphin Pipette will now have the What's Up Bro topic text. But we need one more. Basically, what we need is, well, let's say we've finished the quest. Let's say we've turned everything in, we've given this guy his ring back, and the quest has been done. At the moment, this quest info here, this Some Lemon Stole My Ring What's Up Bro, would actually still appear. Because as far as the game knows, that's just a standard default dialogue option. So what we need to do is set a condition that this quest text only appears at stage 0 of the quest. Remember we set stages a minute ago? 0 is before you've met Dolphin. And that is the only time we want this text to appear, while you're still on stage 0 on the text, before you've killed the bandit. So we're going to right click, click new, and we're going to change this to son of a bitch, I can't remember. I'm going to go check. So we're going to change this to get stage. Let's just search for that. Get stage, and obviously, as you can tell, that will now search request stage. We're going to go to invalid again, and we need to go find our quest. So it's new quest. Click OK. So now that's saying get stage. So check the stage of the quest, and then depending on what we write in this bit here, it will either show or not show the dialogue. So a comparison, this is saying, is it equals to that stage? So value 0. You get what I mean. Basically, it's checking the stage of the quest. The comparison equals sign, so you could have it so under 10. So you could say any stage under stage 10 of the quest would then promote this dialogue option. Or equals, so at stage 0 of the quest, which is the stage of the quest we want people to be at when they have this dialogue option. At stage 0 of the quest, because that's what equals means, this dialogue option will be present. When you're writing dialogue, you want to use equals and then set it to the stage of the quest that you want this dialogue option to appear. Yeah, that does make sense. I promise you it makes sense. Set the comparison, just go for equals usually, or you could do under 10 if necessary, and then value 0. That way, at stage 0 of this quest, this dialogue option will be present. Okay, we're going to click OK. Hope that does make sense. As always, if you have any questions, feel free to ask on the video. Now, one thing we're going to do, we're going to double click our response text here. You do have to click OK the first time and then bring this window back up to do this. And we're going to go down to record. This is where you record dialogue for your quest. So if you want to record custom dialogue, this is where you do it. Now, as a warning, you have to record dialogue. You full on have to. Doesn't necessarily have to have words in it. You can record blank silence for a few minutes if you want, just however long it takes you to read the text. Make sure you've got subtitles on. But you need some form of audio file attached to this response. Otherwise, what will happen is the response will pop up and then vanish instantly. Because there's no audio to tie it into, they don't know how long to display the information for. So until we add audio, before the game knows, you know, you've read it, it's gone, or he said it really quickly, or something like that. Basically, you need audio. So if you're a bit nervous, you don't want to have your own voice in the game, click record, record some silence, basically record however long it takes you to read the text, and maybe a little bit more. Always give them enough time to read the text fully, and then you can cancel your recording. However, for the purpose of this video, I'm going to now very poorly act out this response text. I look forward to it. Some lemon stole my ring. He took it to Nax's tomb to do God knows what with it. Do me a favour, lad. Go and rescue it. Ta. Potato. And that's all it is. I should probably have actually slowed down a little bit because that's a little bit quick. That's probably too long for them to read it. They'd have to hear it, which is probably pretty much impossible given the terrible accent I just did. But he's a poor excuse for Irish. So that's the plan. And then we just click... click save. Click save. And then click OK. And now when we go on text and say, what's up bro, he will say that text out loud with that terrible accent and the text will pop up. And the text at the bottom, if you've got subtitles on, will last as long as my little voice recording just then lasted. Click OK. Click OK. And that, finally, is the first branch of our text completed. The process from here on out is pretty much the same. All we're going to do is we're going to make a new one. So what we want to do is right click inside this outside box here. You need to make sure you have the add topic option available. And what we're going to do is going to create a second response after the some lemon stole my blah 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 text has gone. So we're going to call this new quest and yes. What we want is he's going to say, would you help me out? And then we're going to either have a yes option or a no option. So as always, well, we want to change the ID. This is going to be our yes option. The topic text is going to be the option that we click on after the first option has been clicked on. So we're going to call this sure thing, bro. I'll help you out. I'm not doing anything else today. As you see, you do have a number count here, which is your limit. Responses are limited more than... No, topics are limited more than responses. And then we need, again, to make a response to that topic text. When we click, sure thing, bro, I'll help you out, I'm not doing anything else today, we need him to say, oh, thank you very much, blah, blah, blah. So, response text, let's just say, that'd be dandy, lad. Tar. Like I said, he's in Nax's tomb, go chop his head off and get me my ring back. Again, we can set emotion type. Again, when you click, it will pop up with a spell check. And then we can set emotion type. We're going to have him happy because, you know, we're so happy that we're going to go and get him his ring. Click OK and we'll be back on the topic info box. Again, we need to set the condition. Get his ID. We always, every single response, you need to set this condition. Otherwise, this response will somehow appear on every NPC in the game. Just always make sure you're right-clicking in the conditions box once you set the response. Right-clicking, new condition, get his ID, and then find out. Well, find your quest giver. New quest actor, click OK. All the rest is fine, click OK. We don't need to set the quest stage. The reason being for that is that the first stage of this dialogue option was linked to stage 0. So you can't actually get to this stage of dialogue. Well, you could, but you won't be able to in a second. You wouldn't be able to get to this stage of dialogue without going through the first one, which required you to be at stage 0. So we don't need to add that on top of it. We do, however, need to add our dialogue option. Dialogue. So we're going to record again. And again, you guys can look forward to some fantastic Irish accent. That'd be dandy, lad. Ta. Like I said, he's in Nax's tomb. Go chop his head off and get me my ring back. I'm going to talk for a couple of seconds, just so it's a bit longer. Like I said, I should probably slow down. We need more time to let people who aren't playing with sound on, or people who don't really hear that well, or people who can't understand me. They need time to be able to read the text. I'm going to save that. Click OK. And now, we need to do something terrifying. We need to set a stage. We need to do a little bit of scripting. We're going to use this script I've got here. It's not a big deal. Don't want you to worry about it. I'm going to leave this in the description as always, and I'll quickly explain what it is. GetOwningQuest basically just means this script and this dialogue option is attached to the quest, the current quest we have built this dialogue in. So all that means is this script is attached to the quest Dolphin's Turmoil. SetObjectiveDisplayed isn't something you need to worry about. We will go through that at a later stage. SetStage 10. What SetStage 10 does is it pushes the quest onto the next stage. So we've gone from meeting Dolphin and not knowing what he's on about, blah blah blah, never knowing who he is, to stage 10. And stage 10 is the stage where we've got the quest and we're off to kill the bandit. Killing the bandit stage 20, getting the ring quest stage 30, and returning the ring quest stage 40. Again, I will leave this script in the description, and you want to put it into the end bit here. Now, these scripts, and these are called script fragments, these little bits here. These script fragments go in beginning or end. End happens at the very end of the dialogue option, basically while he's talking, and begins at the start. This allows you to do things like if you want him to glow or something, and the scripts that give you items or scripts that make people teleport and stuff like this, you could have it right at the start of the dialogue or at the end. Now obviously we don't want him to go on to the next stage of the quest until the end of his dialogue option. So we're going to paste that into Papyrus fragment, like I said, it's a script fragment, and there you go. Basically that will now, once we've talked to him the first time and then we've talked to him the second time and said, sure thing bro, I'll help you out, he's going to say the dandy lad, yeah. He's going to say that'll be dandy lad, blah blah blah, and then once that's completed, the quest that we're on, which is why it says get owning quest, the current quest we're on related to this dialogue, which is Dolphin's Turmoil, will then set the stage of that quest to 10. So that means stage 10 of the quest will begin. Stage 10, of course, was we've got the quest essentially. If you have numbered it differently and you know you've called this stage 1, you'd get rid of the 0 and call it stage 1. But obviously we didn't. So we're going to call it stage 10. I'm trying to explain this as simply as possible. Hopefully that does make sense. And once you've got that there, you want to click compile, which basically checks your script for errors and sort of tightens it all up. Hopefully nothing pops up, it shouldn't. And we can go ahead and click OK. And give that a second. Give that many seconds. So, let's go back. Oh god. Render window, what are you doing? You're very much in the way. Let's go back into here. And this is our topic, that's all finished, we're going to click OK. Oh, don't know why that stretched so much, we can just knock that down. Show all text. And as you see, we've now got the initial topic here, and we've got new quest yes here. That's the yes option. We now need to create the no option. Let's just put that back up there. So, we've got the first option, we've got the second option. Sorry, I'm getting a little confused here. I'm not. It's all good. We say hello to him. He tells us someone Lemon stole his ring. Then we have two options. We have, sure bro, I'll help you out. Or what we need is the second option that says, no, I'm not going to help you out. What the hell's wrong with you? Or something to that effect. So again, we're basically going to do exactly what we just did. We're going to right click. We're going to add topic. Going to add topic text, so this is what we say, this is the other option, this will go next to sure bro, we'll help you out, and this will be the other option selectable. This is going to be no, I'm busy, why do I care about your ring, what the hell is wrong with you, ? And again we're going to right click in the box here, which is our response box, remember. We're going to right click, we're going to click new, and response text. Oh well, that sucks. I really did love that ring, and I worry about what he's going to do with it. Ungodly things, I bet. Just make something up. Emotion type. He's going to be, let's say, sad again, because, you know, you've said no, you're not going to take the ring. Let's make him sad. Click OK. Conditions, again, we need to set the same one. We need to get his ID. We need to set it to Dolphin Pipette. Otherwise, again, this option is going to start popping up on other random quest givers. Just make sure you're always doing this. It's a nice habit to get into, and it doesn't take long at all. Well, it doesn't when your computer decides to load faster than, you know, that. Click new, and new quest actor, click OK. If anything I'm doing here does take a long time to load, when you're doing it, don't fret about it, don't try clicking around and closing and stuff, just give it a few seconds. The creation kit has got to load a lot of data, so sometimes it can take quite a while. Click OK. And again, we need to go record some dialogue, so we double click on the response up here. Or we don't, because it hates me. Come on. There we go. And we click record again. Oh, well that sucks. I really did love that ring. And don't worry about what he's going to do with it. Ungodly things, I'd bet. Oi. Done. Bam. Save. Done. Okay. Now, as you remember last time, we had a script here. We had this script here. And it set the stage of the quest to 10. Once that was finished. obviously we said no to his proposal for the quest, so we don't actually want that script there. We don't want to move on to stage 10 of the quest, because we've said no, we don't want the quest. If we did set it to stage 10, then when we went to talk to him again to try and get the quest again, the initial dialogue option wouldn't be there. If you remember, we set the initial dialogue option, the very first thing we said to him, we set that dialogue option to get stage 0. So that means that only appears at stage 0 of the quest. So if we go and set this to stage 10, then once we've said no once, the quest will never appear again. Obviously that's useful sometimes if you want a permanent option, but for the purposes of this, we don't want that to happen. So we're going to go ahead. Actually, we're not going to click, okay? What we're going to click is goodbye as well. I should have done this in the other one. You'll see it here in this little bit here. Don't need to worry about the other stuff. What we need is goodbye. All this means is, once we've clicked that dialogue option and he said everything, the conversation will finish. Instead of going back and having the same options again, which is a little weird and a little annoying, make sure you're ticking goodbye at the end of your dialogue chain. We also want to click, well, we don't want to click, but for subtitle, if, say, you've got a monster in the game or something and you want the player to understand what they're saying, even players who don't have subtitles, even if the monster is just going bah, 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 and talking in a different language or something, you can tick for subtitles and then they'll know for sure what they're saying, even if they don't have subtitles usually enabled. I'm going to click OK. Click OK. Oh, yes, got to change the ID, sorry about that. I'm going to change ID new quest, no. Because this is the no option. Click OK. And there's our quest. I'm going to just quickly go ahead and double click on our new quest, yes. Because we need to tick that goodbye box that I showed you a second ago. To make sure that... to make sure that when that quest option has finished, the conversation ends. You know, he's giving you the quest. He doesn't need to say anything else. Click OK. Click OK. And there we go. We're nearly done. We've got the first bit here, we go up to him, we say, what's up lad, oops, hit my mouse. He will say, some lemon stole my ring, he took it, blah blah blah. We will then be given two options, we will be given the sure thing bro, I'll help you out, or the no, I'm busy, why do I care about your ring. Depending on which option we pick, it will either push the quest to the next stage, which is stage 10, as judged by this one here, or it will end the quest, it will end the conversation and keep the quest at stage 0. So when we go talk to him again, this option will pop up again. What we need to do is create a branch though. I'm gonna just you can drag these about and move them about if you want. I like to have it like this kind of order, so you've got the first quest sort of stage there and then you've got your branching choices there. It's dead easy to link these together because at the moment these are just three floating things within the same view, but they're not actually attached. You know, the game does not know which branch order these go in. For all the game knows is it goes there to there to there. We know it doesn't. So what we need to do is figure out how to do this again, because I've completely forgotten. Yes. You want to click on this grey box on the left here. Nope. Basically, you want to click on the... sorry, I'm getting confused. You click in and... Oopsie daisy. Click on the box you want to link. So this is the first option. We want it to link to there, and we want it to link to there. What we do is we click on the box... That'll highlight it purple, and as you can see, my mouse has now gone to like a little hand, and this allows us to drag to another box. And I don't know why it's on that bit there, but as you can see, there's one chain coming off, and then it either goes to there or there, depending on our... It's linking that first choice. Once that dialogue's over, it will then offer us those two choices. If we then completed two more dialogue choices up here, we could link that one to that one and to that one, or we can link that one to one, that one to one. Basically, you click on the box, and as you see, we could actually drag that into there and have that option linked to that, which obviously isn't something we want, but it's an option. This has been a bloody long tutorial, but that is right there the basics of how you form dialogue for a quest, and obviously the same principles will apply to normal dialogue as well. The last thing to do is go ahead and try that out in game. That is the starting quest of our... That's the starting part of our quest tutorial. Obviously, you know, there's not much else there. What we should do at this point is go and create the end dialogue, but we're going to do that in the next video because this is getting on a little bit too much. But there's so much more to do. We've got to add the ring to the game. We're going to add the enemy. We've got to get him into Naxx's tomb. Blah, 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 blah. Tell you one thing we didn't do though, we didn't put him in our game. So as you see there, all I did at the bottom right was click OK. That quest is now done. It's got the dialogue options. It's not done, but we've got the initial dialogue. What we're going to do is go to Naxx's tomb. No, we're not. We're not going to put him in Naxx's tomb. That's where the enemy's going to go. I find a good place to put people is Dragon Bridge and Four Shields. I tend to put my NPCs in here. It's just a nice little pub, basically. So you go to your cell view, go to interiors, find wherever you want your quest giver to be. If you've made them a dungeon, if you made them a house or something, that's fine. Just stick them in there. Make sure you've nav meshed. But if you just want to put them in a regular inn or a tavern and just have them as a regular quest giver, go ahead and just stick them in Whiterun Inn or Dragon Bridge Inn, as I'm about to do here. So here we are in the Four Taverns pub. We need to go back to our actor. Give that a second. We're going to type for new just to find it quicker. And there's our new quest actor. Drag him in. Should be our naked Khajiit. Yep, there he is. Looking all beautiful. There is Dolphin Puppet. Now, theoretically, when we go talk to him in game, he should tell us. Well, we should have the option, what's up, bro? He should tell us about his ring. We will then have the option to either say yes, which will then set us to stage 10 of the quest, and he will no longer have dialogue options because his only dialogue option was reliant on it being stage 0. Or we will say no, in which case we'll be able to ask him again about the quest. That should be all good. Only thing we need to do now is file and save. And we're going to go give this a try out in game. See you there in a second, guys. Cheers. So here we are in the Four Shields Tavern, and there he is. There is Dolphin Puppet, looking beautiful as always.
How can I assist?
Now, obviously, the problem here is we've given him a default voice, and then we've recorded a voice for him. So they're going to clash. But you could set no voice to him, and then he wouldn't talk generally like that. Talk? So there you see, there's our first dialogue option. What's up, bro? Pops up with the text there. Now the problem is I've actually fallen victim to quite a rare bug, and it's a file name-ish problem. It's a big problem that's very, very, very rare, and they're working on solving it, but I have unfortunately fallen victim to it. It is fixable, and if you go on the Creation Kit website into the dialogue-y section, there's a little guide at the bottom. What I'll do is I'll copy and paste it into the comment section of this video. If you fall victim to it, feel free to fix it, but for the vast majority of you, what I showed you in the video should work and your voice should appear in-game, or at the very least, the silence you recorded should appear in-game. So that's a shame, but it's not a big deal at the end of the day. And as you can see though, it's worked perfectly. We have the two dialogue options, sure thing bro, I'll help you out, or no, I'm busy, why do I care about your ring? Let's go ahead and click that one. That sucks. And as you can see, the conversation's finished. And if you talk to him again, it's reverted back to the very first option in the dialogue. Click what's up, bro. And this time, if we click sure thing, bro, and then talk to him again,
need something.
He doesn't give us that dialogue option anymore. Because we've been moved up to stage 10 of the quest because of saying yes, and his initial dialogue required stage 0, he no longer has anything to say to us. And at this point, we could then go on, and we've got to do lots of things. We've got to get the stage. We've got to get the quest to stage 30. We've got to add bandits. We've got so much more to do to get a fully working quest, guys. But we will pull through it, and I promise you, once you've done this a few times, once you're a bit more used to it, the whole process will be so much quicker. But until then, we do have fully working dialogue, except the little voice bug. But that is just a rare error of the game, and for most of you, like I said, what I showed you should work. Well done. If you
take this the wrong way, but you look a little sickly.
Well done if you made it this far. This has been by far the longest tutorial I've ever done, but as you can tell, dialoguing and quest building is quite a complicated region and requires a lot of work, especially when you're first getting used to it. But either way, I hope it helped. Please go try it out, get some of your own dialogue into the game. Let me know if any of you also have the same bug with the voice recording not popping up, or at the very least your audio silence not popping up. But other than that, I think we're done. For now, that's all we're going to do. Next tutorial, hopefully we're going to finish this quest off, because I think we've got the harder part of this done. All we're going to do next time is add a custom amulet to the game, a custom ring, I should say, to the game. Add our bandit, who's just going to be a regular bandit. We're going to give him a name. We're going to stick the two of them together in the dungeon, and then we're going to make the quest link all these objects together. So that's what we're going to do next time. Thank you for joining me. As always, please do like, comment, subscribe. More likes and comments and views and subscriptions to get from this, the more inclined I am to keep making these tutorials. Obviously, I'm going to keep doing it anyway, but I might do it a little bit faster. Because otherwise I have to go and actually earn money like a normal person, which is rather annoying. But that's about it. Thank you, as always. Dolphin Puppet, he thanks you too. You know, he looks fantastic in his... I'm going to walk away from him. But yeah, much love, guys, as always. Thank you for watching. I shall see you in the next video. Bye-bye.